Oh, come on, you got it. Make that angel.
All right, guys, so Matt and me had a free day today, and we literally had nothing else to do. Our entire day was free, and I was like, you know what? I'm gonna take you to Six Flags, because I personally love roller coasters. That's something that makes me, like, forget about everything when I just ride roller coasters all day, and
Zane, I don't know, just... we shouldn't be going to Six Flags. Like, we need to be doing something that's more wintry, more getting us in the season.
More,
you know?
Wintry? Dude, we're in California. There's literally nothing in this state. What do you?
Yes.
You want to go ice skating in like the rinks with fake ice? I mean, we could do that, but that's not in the.
Dude, no.
That's not the full winter spirit,
Zane,
you know.
Let's go skiing.
We can't go skiing. We're in California.
No. There is like a legit ski resort that's
Watch
like
out.
An hour
Vehicle
and 30 minutes away. We could
ahead.
Totally go to.
I don't believe you.
No, I'm serious.
It's real snow.
It's a whole mountain filled with snow.
Are you serious?
Yes. We can go right now. It's just like up and around the freaking mountain.
Dude, let's fucking go there.
Let's go skiing. Ooh, baby, do you know what that's worth? Ooh, heaven is a place on earth. They say.
Oh my god.
All right, Zane, you ready?
No, that thing went. Boom.
Watch out, Winter Olympics, baby. Zane Hajans is coming for you. Oh no,
Zane, that's the mud. That's the mud.
That is not a pizza, Zane.
Oh, Matt, look at you. You ate it. What's it called?
We're at Mountain High Ski Resort.
I have never skied before. I've never done any like snow sport. And we just see the first lift and we get on it, get to the top.
You all right?
What's
yeah,
up?
I'm all right.
You all right?
Around. People saw me take a spill, dude.
Like, look at you, man.
No, this is what happened. We go up a lift that is completely out of our league. The only levels are like intermediate and expert. And I get up there and I'm taking a look at it. Zane's like, you know what?
It was way too steep for
Zane
me.
Zane takes the lift.
I had to take the shame down. Everyone's just like, it's okay, man. Not everybody can do it. I'm just like, fuck. It was just so steep. What's the level that like little kids do?
Right here.
The bunny slope?
This one right here.
The bunny slope.
So this is what happens. We're up there and the guy's like, you know what? The snow's pretty good today. You've done this before? I'm like, yeah, you know, I went on a ski trip once. Zane, I was looking good for one day though. I'm going down it like, and I'm going with the momentum, but I'm like, I'm nailing it. And I see like the exit way to go to the kiddie slope. I'm like, kiddie slope on my way. I'm like in the area where all these kids are getting off. I'm doing pizza, baby. This is the
pizza. Oh yeah.
The mud makes it look a lot worse. And then there was this board right by the ski lift and I just slammed into it and all these ski bums come out. They're like, dude, are you okay? Cause I'm covered in mud.
Dude, I'm such a pussy. I wish I went, man. I just couldn't. It was too steep.
You would have been coming down off the stretcher like, you would have been like sky lifted out of there.
You're looking good, buddy. You got this, man.
All right, so Christine called me this morning telling me that she needed to show me something really important and that I needed to head to her place immediately before things got any weirder. And I just got to her house now and I don't know, I'm kind of nervous. So I'm going to bring the camera with me and I'm going to just record what she needs to tell me. And yeah, let's see what's up.
So I'm at her house right now.
Hey.
Hey.
You want to just come in?
Yeah. Okay. What's up?
Have a seat.
Yeah.
So, this might sound kind of weird. I got you a present.
Okay. Where is it?
It's kind of like for Christmas, let's say.
Okay.
You're kind of
making me nervous.
I just feel very strongly about you. You're just a really good friend, and I just want to remember our relationship forever. So it's not so much like a physical gift. I mean, it's physical in that it exists.
Okay.
And I just wanted something just permanent to just show the world, you know, my love for you.
Permanent?
Permanent. In writing on my body.
Christine, you're making me nervous. Well, what is it?
It's a tattoo.
Were you drunk when you got this?
I mean, that's neither here nor there.
Oh my god. Let me see it. Christine!
You don't like it?
It's my Twitter handle.
I know, your tweets are just so funny. I just love them and I wanted...
I don't believe that. Let me see that. Let's pull it up.
It's real.
Oh my god. The verification and everything.
I know, I'm just so proud of you for being verified. I mean, you don't...
That's not something I should be happy about, you know? That's kind of weird. Don't you think?
I thought you'd love it.
Okay, Christine.
It was too soon. Too much.
You know what? You shouldn't feel too bad about this. You know why?
Why?
Because, bitch, I got one too!
All right, so we have a little story on what happened exactly when we got these tattoos. We got these tattoos at some place down Christine Street, and we go in there, and while I was sitting there getting ready, some like homeless lady walks into the place. And were you sitting there? Were you sitting in that area at the moment?
He was still finishing my tattoo, but you were sitting back there with me filming it. Yeah. And this lady walks in, and she's like, "How much for a five-letter tattoo?" And he was like, "I don't know, like $80." And she goes, "Would it cost less if I got it on my coochie?" And the guy was like, "No, like that would cost more." She like leaves, but I want to know what that five-letter tattoo is gonna be.
I know, I completely agree with you, and I don't know if she even asked for it before or after what she did. Basically, Elijah and Julian started recording it, and when they were recording her, and she like started bleeding.
Her nose started bleeding.
They were recording her, and they didn't realize. You see her take my money from the counter. It was wrapped around my charger, and the guy had to go clean up the blood.
And Elijah goes, "Oh, by the way, Zane, I think she stole your charger."
Zane, she stole your phone charger for sure.
Hold on, are you serious?
I'm pretty sure she did.
No, that was my money that she grabbed.
No way.
No way. She left like 2 minutes ago. He's like, "Oh wait, by the way, I think she walked out with your charger."
Did he see it while recording it, or did he see her actually do it?
If you watch, he's got video on his phone of her grabbing.
And I sprint out. At that point, I was on FaceTime with Heath. Just coincidentally, Heath FaceTimed me like a minute before all that happened.
Money.
So I wasn't even recording it. Heath was just watching this as we were FaceTiming.
Oh, well, I'm back in the shop just getting tattooed. Like, what's going on?
So I run up to her and I'm like, "You took my money." And she's like, "Whoa, you scared me." I'm like, "You took my money. It doesn't matter if I scared you or not." And I was like, "Open your hand." She opens her hand and like all my money is there.
Yeah, because you're stealing money. Give it.
There you go. And I grabbed all my money. Forgot about my charger.
Yeah.
She still had my charger. I totally forgot about it. And I walked to him like, "Do you need money?" She's like, "I mean, it'd be nice." And I just gave her a 20. I'm like, why are you stealing people's money? Don't ever steal people's money.
10 minutes later, we're outside. Me and Elijah are outside smoking. And there's a charger on the sidewalk in front of the shop. So I don't know if like you got it and actually dropped it.
No. I think she dropped it off. She felt bad and returned my charger. I started counting my money.
Did she take more?
Oh, yeah. She had 120 in her pocket. So I gave her another 20. So she has 40 now. She played me.
Best part.
But
she was wearing a shirt as pants, just like your vlog intro.
She must watch my vlogs then.
She does.
That was a weird night. I think from start to end, I think yesterday was one of the weirdest days I've ever had.
Definitely. Like, I threw up in a dreidel.
Hey guys, I had a bad night.
I had a bad night too.
I want to talk about something. I just love how our thing is shitty tattoos. I would like-
What you mean our aesthetic?
I mean, look at your tattoos.
Artwork, baby. This is my life and death art sleeve.
Baby, that screams regret. This look at that one right there.
This is my "We're All Mad Here" chest hour cat tattoo. Apatheism chest. Hey, which means you I don't care to choose a religion, but I respect other people's- And this is my bear.
This is my 21 Pilot Shrine.
And then that, what is that?
My 21 Pilot Shrine.
Is that hieroglyphics? Would you like to see a tattoo that I just got?
What the fuck.
How does she pronounce her Twitter handle?
Are you fucking serious? Are you mentally fucking ill? How would you get that on your ankle? Put it up here. Ankle tattoos are for women.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
You showed it to me last night, and I was like, "Why did you get Christine's handle? Why not anyone else? Like, why not my handle? Heath's or something?"
Like, no,
and he goes, "I mean, if you're going to get a bad tattoo, you might as well make it all the way bad."
All right, guys. Thanks for watching. Make sure to like this video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more stuff from me and all my friends. Shout out to Lakeisha. Thank you for liking all my stuff and watching all my videos and keeping up with all my tweets. David, what are you doing?
Put the camera on me.
Why?
Because it's the end of the vlog.